Hello there, my name is Andrew Mwangi and once again I'm so glad that you could join me in this short video clip on the psychology of relationships. Did you know that we all have our own individual personalities and they impact our relationships, even our marriages, in diverse ways? Today we're going to look at yet another personality, and that is the histrionic personality. As we go through this personality, try to locate yourself. Could this be you? And how is it affecting your relationship? And what can you do about it? Now, what kind of people have the histrionic personality? They are fun-loving. They are extroverted. They make good salesmen, but tend to be manipulative, vain, and domineering. Because of their appeal to others, histrionic personalities tend to face more sexual temptations than others. They usually make very attentive lovers. Moreover, they are concerned with gaining first-hand experience on issues. Their life is, they want to have the experience of a good life. Rather than being told how things are, they want to experience it for themselves. Now, a biblical figure for this personality would be Apostle Peter. And this personality has a positive side and a negative side. On the positive side, Ecclesiastes 11 and verse 9 tends to support their lifestyle. It says, "Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes. But know that for all this God will bring you into judgment." And then verse 10 says, "Therefore remove sorrow from your heart and put away evil from your flesh, for childhood and youth are vanity." So, the Bible supports histrionic personalities to that extent, that it is wonderful to enjoy life. Don't just live long. Let your years be full of zest. Let your years be full of passion and joy. But on the negative side, Proverbs 21 and verse 17 says, "He who loves pleasure will be a poor man. He who loves wine and oil will not be rich." What a wonderful balance that the Bible would help the histrionic personalities put in place in their lives. Now, according to DSM-5, which is the Professional Diagnostic Statistical Manual that health practitioners use to diagnose mental disorders, they say that histrionic personality can actually degenerate into a disorder with the following symptoms. Number one, individuals with this personality disorder are uncomfortable in situations in which they are not the center of attention. They can be overly dramatic as they seek to gain the attention of others. This personality can be constant until they go to sleep, seeking attention of others. They tend to flirt a lot. They display rapidly shifting and shallow expression of emotions. They consistently use physical appearance to draw attention to themselves. This individual has a style of speech that is excessively impressionistic and lacking in detail. They can throw around heavy, detailed jargon that they have little understanding of just to draw attention. This individual shows self-dramatization and exaggerated expression of emotion. This individual is easily influenced by others or circumstances. This individual considers relationships to be more intimate than they actually are. They can keep talking about how intimate they are with a certain individual just to draw attention to themselves. Now, this kind of personality should be encouraged to consider the following words of wisdom. Proverbs 25 and verse 17 says, "Seldom set foot in your neighbor's house, lest he become weary of you and hate you." They consider themselves the life of the party, but they can wear out people by their tendencies. Proverbs 25 and verse 27 says, "It is not good to eat much honey, so to seek one's own glory is not glory." So the Bible is cautioning this personality not to seek their own glory. Proverbs 27 verse 2 says, "Let another man praise you and not your own mouth. a stranger and not your own lips. What about Luke 14 and verse number 7 as I conclude? Luke 14 and verse number 7 says, our Lord Jesus told a parable to those who were invited to a feast when he noted how they chose the best places. He said to them in verse 8, when you are invited by anyone to a wedding feast, do not sit down in the best place, lest one more honorable than you be invited by him. And he who invited you come and say to you, give place to this man, and then you begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when you're invited, go and sit down in the lowest place, so that when he who invited you comes, he may say to you, friend, go up higher. Then you will have glory in the presence of those who sit at the table with you. For whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. So if you have these kind of tendencies, sit down with your spouse, with your significant other, with your friends, and discuss how your personality tends to impact your relationship. I pray that as you do so, you will have better ways of relating with each other. You will find better ways of relating in your marriage, in your friendships. And may the good Lord bless you and keep you in Jesus' name.